In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy
Father,
Spirit.
the Son,
Amen.
and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit, they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the
By
light
the
of
light of
Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in His consolation. Through Christ. Amen.
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 From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold the bridegroom, come out and meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." Well, they went off to buy it. The bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. The three pointers, please.
In today's Gospel, from Matthew 25, verses 5 to 6, 8 to 9, to 13. In today's Gospel, this is the first one. When Jesus says, "Stay awake because you do not know the day or the hour," he is urging us to remain vigilant in our faith. Number two, pointer. We have many reasons for thinking that the time for Jesus' second coming, in other words, the end of the world, is still a long way off. On the contrary, Jesus cautions us that this can happen anytime. Moreover, we can also die anytime. The third pointer. Ask yourself this question. Am I ready for Christ's return? Conclude this reflection with this prayer. Father, give me the graces to live my faith vigilantly every day, that you may be glorified at all times. Amen.
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 Thank you very much, Tita Bex. So today's Gospel, it's a warning for us, no? Are you prepared? Are we prepared? So that's the most important message of today's Gospel. Tita Helen, you have something?
Yes, Tita. The title of this reflection is 5 Were Wise. Today's Gospel, which narrates the parable of the 10 virgins, belongs to the 5th discourse. 5 are wise, while 5 are foolish. The wise ones bring with them flasks of oil together with their lamps. The foolish ones bring their lamps, but do not bring extra oil with them. The bridegroom's arrival is delayed. The bridegroom arrives when the foolish virgins are out buying oil. The wise ones go with the bridegroom into the wedding feast. The door is shut. We are called to imitate the wise virgins. Are we like the wise virgins, ready to meet the Lord when He comes? How do we make ourselves ready in welcoming Jesus? Do we recognize that the Lord also comes to us every day? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Tita Helen. So the same, no? Be like the five wise virgins who have extra oil with them, because because they don't know when the bridegroom is coming. Just like us, we don't know when the bridegroom is coming. That means that it's the end of the world, or it's our personal end. So if you notice that you don't have enough oil and the bridegroom has not arrived yet, you went out and buy the extra oil, and then here comes the bridegroom without the five foolish virgins who were not very prepared for the coming of the bridegroom. So it's a good example sa atin nuna. Are we prepared? If the bridegroom comes, are we prepared? If our end comes, are we prepared? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Have we done our mission?
Yeah.
But I have a question. Isn't sharing is loving? Why can't the five wise virgins share their oil with the foolish ones? If we think about the love of
sharing.
God, of neighbor, which is sharing.
Siguro to yeah,
this.
That's yeah, that's a good question, Bel, no? Why not share, no? But the thing is, maybe they can share, but they don't have enough to share. Kasi nga ang oil nila is ang oil ng the oil of these five foolish virgins, no? They need more ba what they have, what the wise virgins have. So and then sharing siguro is I really don't know how the amount of the wise virgins have, but the lesson dito is they went away, the five foolish virgins went away to buy,
went out to buy,
went out to buy
oil.
And then the bridegroom comes. So the lesson is, do we have enough oil in our heart to keep burning ba? until the bridegroom comes, or until the end comes, our end.
So if being prepared is equated to salvation, so don't we have the responsibility also of helping the five foolish being saved?
We can.
Should we think only of ourselves as being saved? Because if we want to be saved, and if we go by the two commandments, then you also share, because you want them to be saved too. Just like we want our children to be saved, we pray for them, we motivate them to deepen the relationship with our Lord. So that's really my that's the one bugging me also when I think about this parable. But
hindi sila nag-help. But on the other hand naman, you also do your part.
Charity begins.
You also do your part. For example, sa akin, I mean, example ito, no? Ako, you guys are praying for me. And you are praying for me, you do your part, but it depends on me. I have to do something also to do good. Mga ganyan ba? So we, as much as we can, the best thing to give them is number one, if we can share, if we have enough to share, no, and then prayers. But you also have to do your part. Para hindi na lang sila mag-depend na I will do this anyway, somebody is praying for me. Mga ganyan ba?
Complacency died because they were given enough time. They forewarned is forearmed. They were given enough time. It was announced that the bridegroom is coming. Yet they just were being complacent and they just didn't do anything but just rested. And then here comes the time. There was enough time for them. They were given such a period.
But I can remember the life of Saint Augustine, that for so many years he was so barumbado. But Saint Monica never gave up on him, prayed and prayed and prayed for him until he got converted. And so if Saint Monica did not pray for him, what could have happened?
He could have been out of the way.
Walang Saint, kaya nga sabi nila, walang Saint Monica, walang Saint Augustine.
Walang Saint Augustine. Ba?
So the bottom line here is, no matter how much we pray ba, and then the person we are praying for, no, doesn't do his part, and then given a chances, and then, you know,
several chances.
Oh, several chances na.
So it's
until the end comes. Oh,
yeah. Already.
That's correct. You know, because salvation is something personal. Eh? Something personal, yeah. You cannot do good things for the other person, okay, para ma-save siya. Gagawa siya. He has to work for his salvation. I cannot work for your salvation. Of course, I can pray, but I cannot work for your salvation. I cannot force you to be saved if you don't want to be saved. You have to work for it. Okay.
So it's still self-directed.
Yeah.
Self-indicated.
Kikilos ka. You have to do your part, sabi ni Ma. Kikilos ka.
Lihok na ako, kitabangan ko ikaw. And I will come to help you.
Help your part. Help yourself also. Mm-hmm.
Parang sabi, parang it's like kita na, imo kalag, imo kargo. Sa narinig ko kay tatay yan, imo kalag, imo kulo. Ibig sabihin, you're responsible to your own salvation. Mm. No? Kalag, like the one that Tito Manny said, you cannot help anybody to save his
soul. Judge by your own.
Imo kalag, imo kulo. Narinig ko yan kay Lolo dati. Imo kalag.
Imo kalag, imo kargo.
Yes.
Imo loko. Loko is ginaano mo eh.
Imo kulo. Kulo mo ginakit.
Ginapasaan.
Ginapasaan. Oo, ginapasaan.
Imo kalag.
Yeah. That's we will ask the thought of Father Danny. What does he think about it? Oh, pero I think as much as we help other people, no, now it all depends on them for their salvation. The most that we can pray is, I mean, the most that we can do is pray for them and help them, you know, like spread the news, you know, all those things. But they have to do their part.
Yeah.
Will sila lang tayo, my free will.
My free will.
There is wailing. May verse doon na there is wailing and thinking outside. You know, if you will not be with the Lord, you will not be saved, and you will go to this other place where there is wailing and whatever.
And grind.
Gnashing.
Because when the time comes, talagang sarado na. Sabi ni Lord, outside ka, I don't know you, diyan ka lang. Stay there.
So,
so we better prepare. It's been we're given time to repent. Pero once na magrepent dai, once na that you repent, like Saint Augustine, dire-diretso na. He closed the door for the other side, and he was with the with God not all the way.
You have to work for your salvation. I cannot confess your sins. You yourself must confess your sins. I cannot confess for you.
Maybe I can help you pray for your forgiveness of forgiveness of your sins. Yun. Kasi gina-pray din natin yan for the forgiveness of the sins of other people ba. Pero they have free will.
Saint Gertrude.
Sa Saint Gertrude. Very important ang ano ni Saint Gertrude, no? for the dead and the living. Okay, Saint Gertrude. So may maganda ako dito, no, about this, no. The charity, the oil is a symbol of charity, no? Charity. And charity should be in action, because charity in action is faith. Yun ang sabi dito. Without faith, there's no charity. So it says here, reflect today upon the high calling you have been given to live an active and manifest life of charity. Spend time reflecting upon what charity truly is. Have you allowed yourself to become guided by a more secular and selfish form of love? Do you act more out of selfish preferences than out of self-giving and sacrifice? Do you truly build people up and witness the love of God to them? Try to answer these questions seriously. This parable spoken from our Lord is much more than a story. It is the truth. It is truth. And the truth is that some will arrive at the day of judgment without the necessary oil for their lamps. Take our Lord seriously and examine your life of charity. Where you are lacking, become fervent in your mission to change. In the end, you will be eternally grateful you did. So ang charity, pwede natin ma-share. I-share natin ang charity. And then, i-share na. As much as we can, we share the charity. We share the faith. We share the love of God. We have to do all these Christian things, no? To help them. To pave the way, to help them, to educate them. But the bottom line is free will. Yun pa rin. But sometimes because of deep prayer siguro, the free will of other people, no, can be changed, no, because can be changed by the Holy Spirit because of our prayers. Charity pa rin yan, in the form of prayers. So let's keep on praying, no, let's keep on praying for each other, praying for those lost souls, ba, lost ways, those people with the who have lost their ways towards their salvation.
Kaya nga, five wise and five foolish. Ten virgins, but five were wise and five were foolish. So I'll just read this. To be on the alert does not mean to live with fear and anguish. It means to live our life as sons of God, our life of faith, hope, and charity in a responsible way. The Lord is continuously waiting for our response of faith and love, constant and patient amid the chores and preoccupations that we weave our life. And then, and this response can only be given by us, you and I. Nobody else can give it in our place. See, kanya-kanya yan, no? This is what it means. The denial of the sensible maidens to the careless ones to share their oil for their lamps that were going out says, go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves. And it says, our response before God, which is personal, no, is therefore personal and not transferable. Yeah, see? Person, not transferable.
Non-transferable.
Relationship with God is our response. Hindi mo siya mapipilit na magkuhan kay Lord, you know. But we can help him through
we
charity.
We can pray for the change of heart. Charity. For the change of heart. Kasi we are also witnesses. We are also witnesses na because of our charity, because of our prayers, somebody has returned back to the path, to the good path or for the right path. Natin. Marami tayong mga na-witness. So the bottom line here is let's keep on praying, especially for those people, for those five foolish virgins. Para naman may change of heart. Our prayers can help really. So amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Do you have something, Belle? Ano, ang iba?
Sa, ano, Catholic mom. My father had a saying he liked to invoke whenever I was in a hurry. He would say that I had one foot on a banana peel, the other one out of the door. It meant that I was such a rush, I was likely to sabotage myself. My mother would often chime in, pleading with me to slow down. She was an individual who saw the wisdom in taking time to smell the roses. She thought, quiet, rightly, that the good things in life were passing me by. So regrettably, I can really identify with the foolish virgins who brought no oil for their lamps. All too often, I am the fool who rushes in where angels do not tread. You would think, after being burned so many times, I would learn my lesson. But in an instant, I can forget the valuable lessons of the past and repeat my folly. It is high time for me to wise up. Maybe you feel the same. We can all relate to that feeling of dread when we find ourselves unprepared, whether it is for a test in the classroom or a test in marriage. None of us knows the day or the hour when Jesus will come knocking on our door to take us home. Therefore, it's important to prepare now before it is too late. Because it's all about being prepared, right, for the second coming of Jesus. If you have not been to confession for a while, why not make a resolution to return this week? Nothing can beat the feeling of serenity that comes with having one's sins forgiven. Christ is ready and willing to extend mercy to us, if only we seek it. Take time to be wise. By being prepared, we can enjoy time eternal with the Lord. So in what ways this week can I prepare for Christ's coming? Through confession.
Confession.
Being sorry for our sins.
Yeah.
Reconciliation.
Sacrament of Reconciliation. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So that's how we fill up our oil, no? Sacrament of Reconciliation.
Yeah.
we can fill up our oil.
Let's keep our faith burning. And faith without action is dead. So faith must be equal to action.
Charity without faith is not charity. And faith without action is not faith.
True.
Beautiful, no? Beautiful message. So, anybody else who wants to say something?
Last paragraph.
Please go ahead, Tito Mans.
Let God give us the grace of His mercy that we may not have to hear in the supreme hour. Amen, I say to you, I will not know you. It is Matthew 25, verse 12. That is, you have had no relation whatsoever with me. Yun ang nangyari dun sa mga virgins na foolish. So let us treat the Lord in this life in such a way that we may become His acquaintances and friends in our time and in eternity. Amen.
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 Yun. Yung mga foolish, they had no relationship whatsoever. See? So, sabi nga kanina, non-transferable yun. You have to act on your own na. Of course, we can pray for that person, but he must act also. Do something. No? But we can help him, inspire him. But if he doesn't act, because you cannot force somebody who doesn't want to be saved. Yun ang bigat ng free will. Eh. God cannot save you if you do not want to be saved. Walang magagawa ang Diyos. Eh? Even if He is God. Because He gave that person a free will. And He cannot violate that free will. Yun ang kuhan yan.
So to each his own salvation, kumbaga.
Yeah, so.
To each his own salvation.
You cannot save that person. You cannot force that person to be saved. He doesn't want to.
So bottom line dito is let's really keep on praying for them. For the conversion of sinners.
Ni Monica, di ba?
May Saint Monica na example tayo. May mga taga dito sa prayer warrior natin na good example. And many, many more.
Basta pray. Hindi, pag ayaw, wala ka magagawa. Hindi kasi sisihin ni Lord. You save yourself, but He may not be saved.
Tapos sabi pa siguro ni Lord, I've given you enough time. I have given you enough time.
Many second chances.
Many second chances. Second chances. Second chances. So
you offer, ang maganda dyan is you offer your communions also for that person for his conversion. Yan yun eh. Offer,
wow. Pray, that's nice, communion. Like 2 months. Mm-hmm. Offer our communions.
That's why in our prayers, basta soldiers of Mary, we always offer every day, no? We always mention, no? For the forgiveness of the sins of others, especially our loved ones, and for the conversion of sinners, we offer our prayers. Yun ang gina-offer din natin sa St. Gertrude natin eh. Conversion of sinners. So, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. I think that's it for today, for today's gospel reading and reflections. So, may we have the closing prayer?
Okay.
Dear God, thank you that your love is perfect. You are kind. You are good. We cannot love others well without your power. help us to face the areas of our life that are not marked by love, and take bold stages towards forgiveness and healing. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And all together, please, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. Love you guys. Thank you.
Love you. Bye.
Take care.